Hi everyone, so now we are going to talk about the last application of Bohr's law, that is electric field due to a hollow charge spherical shell. Okay, if there is a hollow charge spherical shell, then what will be the electric field? Okay, so we will discuss. This is the simplest application, like it's we don't have to use that much logic here, it's very easy only. So there are three cases here. We will discuss one case and second case and third, three cases like this, 1, 2, and 3. So it's very easy only. So all of you listen. First case, there is a hollow charge shell. So this is a charge shell which has some charge. So you can consider sigma something. Okay, it's fine. So look at this. Suppose we have to find out the electric field at this point, outside point T. This is the first case. Second case, this is the second case. Why I am discussing all these cases one by one, like together, because then you will get that idea. Okay. So here, this is the second case, that is electric field due to this charged shell on the surface of this charge. This is the surface. Here the point is P, here. Next one, third one. That is, this is a charged shell, same charged shell. So I am not good with drawing. Please excuse me. It's almost like a shell, huh? Okay, fine. So this is charged shell, and one point we'll consider here inside. The P is inside. Okay. Let's discuss each one. So let's say the radius of this one is R, and the charge on the surface, that is equal to Q, and radius is equal to R here, and here also radius is equal to R. Okay, this is the case, not capital R, small r. Okay, this is the case. First case we will discuss. So let's say this is a thing. We want to find out the electric field at this point, outside point. Let's say the distance to that point is equal to capital R. Then we have to find out the Gaussian surface. The Gaussian surface, it is very easy. It is nothing but it is another sphere, hollow sphere. It would be another hollow sphere. Then we will consider, all of you listen, then we will consider this Gaussian surface. And what is the charge enclosed in it? Q. Okay. So integral, surface integral E dot dA, which is equal to Q enclosed divided by epsilon 0. So what is, this is what the Gauss law, and what is integral E dot dA? E into dA. So E electric field into, let me ask you another question. What about the direction? Look at the direction. Suppose when we consider this small area dA, and the direction is similar, like direction is same, and electric field direction same. So E dot dA you can consider E into dA. Okay. Because theta is equal to 0, theta is equal to 0 degree, and E into integral dA. How much is integral dA? How much is integral dA? It will be the total area of this sphere, bigger sphere, not smaller one. Because we always consider the area of the Gaussian surface. Okay, so E into 4 pi r square, capital R square, is equal to Q enclosed by epsilon 0. And what about the electric field? Electric field will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 take this side into Q by R square into R cap. That is a vector one, R cap. Okay, the direction is in this direction, normal to the Gaussian surface. Okay, this is what is the equation. Look at this, it's very easy only, right? Now look at this. On the surface, the point P is on the surface. And radius is equal to small r. Here again the equation, integral E dot dA is equal to let's consider here dA is equal to Q by epsilon naught. But the problem here it is, we don't have to consider a separate Gaussian surface here, because already it's a sphere, it's a symmetrical sphere. So I can say that it is electric field into. How much is the angle? Angle E is in this direction. Normal vector is also in this direction. So both are same. E into integral dA. How much is integral dA? 4 pi r square. Look at this. What is this integral dA? That is the integral of dA. That is the total area. How much is the total area? 4 pi r square. Small r square. Okay. C equal to Q by epsilon 0. And what about E? E is equal to? E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q upon r square. Vector. Put the vector also. Okay. This is what is the equation. And look at this. This value will be constant throughout the surface. This value will be constant in all, because that is why we are saying it's equipotential, right? We have already discussed that. And the field will be same, or the potential at every point will be same. Okay. And next one, look at this. What about inside? Inside, integral E dot dA is equal to Q enclosed divided by epsilon 0. Let me ask you one question. How much will be the Q enclosed when the point P is at this point, or point P is at this point? Let's say this distance is R dash. How much will be the value? The Q enclosed will be 0. The Q enclosed will be equal to 0. Because there is, suppose when you consider a Gaussian surface like this, okay, including that point, then how much will be the Q enclosed in this? 0. Because all the charges are distributed along the surface or along the area of the sphere. So there is no Q. Here Q enclosed will be equal to 0. So what is this value? Electric field is equal to 0. Electric field is equal to 0 inside. Okay. These are the three cases. These are the three cases of a hollow charged shell by using Gauss's theorem. And there is one graph. We can draw one graph here. Let's say this is the graph. This is electric field versus distance. Let's say this is x. X is the distance. Okay. So let me start with this. This is R, capital R, and here is a point. Okay. And how would be the graph? The graph would be like this. Okay. What about here? Here the value is equal to 0. That is, this is 0, this is the center, origin. From origin to R, it will be, from origin to R, it will be 0. Here no values. What about at R? The value will be maximum. How much will be this value? It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R square. Then the value will be decreasing. How much is this? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by capital R square. Capital R square. So, this is the graph which relates electric field versus x. The value is first 0, from 0 to R it is 0. Then it will be at, like, it was at the maximum 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R square. Then it will be decreasing like this. Okay. The relation is E is proportional to 1 by R square. We all know this. Okay. By using Coulomb's law also we can follow the same, or we can deduce the same equations. So this is what is the third application of Gauss's law. So we have discussed all the types of Gauss's law. We have to solve some more problems on this. So we'll see you on the next class.